because I'm a very lazy person. You know, my name I don't want to talk about all the time because I just had a great this ceremony is nice and short and sweet and beautiful, and I don't think the speech should take longer than that. And I don't really have a lot of good anecdotes to tell about Bret and I because there's a lot of younger mixed age company here. I think that it's very appropriate, but what I really want to say and what I think is the most important thing to me is that I've been Bret for a long time. It's going on 14 years now. And, you know, I've gone through a lot of nice times. We've had our stretches of a lot of darkness and hard times together. And in that time, I always thought I knew Bret really well. You know, I called him my best friend. He's a great guy. But after he met Jess, I mean, immediately after, within moments, he came over like the next day and was telling me how amazing this woman was. I saw parts of Bret I'd never seen before. I'd never realized how much joy there was in life, how much desire there was to experience happiness and just stretch his wings and try new things. I mean, this is a man whose idea of an exotic dinner was putting the ketchup on his hamburger rather than dipping the hamburger in the ketchup. You know, they eat Indian food and Thai, they cook together. He actually knows what vegetables taste like right now. That's thanks to her. And I didn't have the good fortune to know her before she knew Brad, before, you know, I knew Brad, whatever, you get one, but I sure would have done. But I imagine it's the same way because I've seen how close they are together and how much joy he brings to her, how much happiness. You know, you go to their house and they've got cute notes written to each other, poetry on the fridge, and all these wonderful things, and they hold each other's hands and they kiss and they say they love each other. And they're happy and ashamed of it, and they like to explore and go on these adventures together. And for me, it's been this immense privilege in my life to see this. You know, to see not only meet people who are already happy together, but, you know, to have a guy who is my best friend and who is wonderful always. I mean, I call him my best friend. He's wonderful to begin with. But to see him grow and change so much so quickly and to find this great happiness that these two people share, well, I think it's absolutely fantastic. And so they've actually given me an incredibly embarrassing task. They asked all of you now to write haiku. And I have now read all the haiku that has been written to them. And I've selected three of them. And I didn't pick them on like their quality or their embarrassment factor. Because really that would be a very difficult decision. So I just picked ones I thought were pretty funny or pretty entertaining. So I thought that I would read three of them right here for you right now, and then I'm going to give the microphone to Elizabeth. So the first one here, and I'm not going to say who they're from. You can take credit for that or shame for that at your own. But the first one, marriage is super. You guys are a lot of fun. We shall have some booze. And also, I'd like on that note to remind you, the bar will be open after all of this stuff. So the second one is, and I think it's very important. Everybody here probably understands the wisdom of marriage. Marriage can be bliss. We'll change the toilet paper one out. Always put the seat down. And I think here, my favorite, and I think this probably sums up sort of what I was saying before, is we have not met Bret, but Jess buys only the best. All sales are final.